Digital Performer is a product of the Mark of the Unicorn Company, and I am in no way associated with Mark of the Unicorn. Okay, in this tutorial, we're going to speak about powered plugins. Powered plugins, in all essence, are a hardware-dedicated software plugin. Instead of a native plugin, is using the computer's CPU to do the processes for you. Whether as a hardware plugin, a powered plugin, has a card or a FireWire device that is used along with the software for the plugin. Let's take a look at this one. This is a screenshot of a powered plugin. This is a Universal Audio LA-2A. It's a dynamics processor. As you notice up here, if we zoom in on the DSP performance meter, this is where your hardware is sitting, right? You know, with the performance of the card. This is how many resources you're using within the hardware. When you come over here to these plugins, the more plugins you add, the more your CPU usage will go up on the card. One thing nice about these is they kind of keep the processing down on the on the actual CPU of the computer. But they're really nice. They have a little bit better quality than a lot of the native plugs. But it's a subjective thing. So everybody kind of likes what they like. I have a tendency to go a little bit more for the UAD stuff or some of the SSL Duende stuff. Sonox, the Oxford plugins are really nice. There's a lot of really nice plugins out there for your DOS, and but powered plugins are the way to go because it takes a lot of your DSP resources off of your computer, so you can your computer can do more things like automation and running the actual hard disk recording system and taking care of like virtual instrument plugins and what have you. So as you can see, powered plugins with the DSP usage meter, you can tell right away that it's going to take less DSP resources from your host application. So they really work out well for high track counts and where you want a very good quality of plugin. Powered plugins are the way to go.